Then you find a taxman who will tell you, I will shoot you or I will kill you and nothing will happen. But the gentleman is correct. Nothing will happen. Because in the past, people have killed and nothing has happened. How many cases have been investigated by the IG? How many? How many SARS personnel have been held, you know, as culprits and made to face the law? So the man is right when he stops you in your car and discusses with you and tells you, if you are not careful, I will waste you and nothing will happen. And he tells you to your face. Frankly speaking, I've sat in the car once with my family, my wife and kids. I was stopped by a policeman. I was a mufti. I didn't bother to introduce myself in my usual way because I feel allowed the gentleman to do his job. But you will not believe he started stepping beyond his bounds. When eventually he discovered, fine, I am an army colonel, I expected that as a disciplined security man, you come to attention and pay me my regards. He was asking me, hey, so what do you have for the boys now? Hey, bloody sergeant, you are asking me, after knowing who I am? I'm disappointed. I looked at him, I said, well, I don't blame you. I blame the training you had because my driver wouldn't do that to your boss. It's unfortunate. And while I kept talking, my wife became jittery that, look, this man is holding a weapon. Drive off, baby, before this man begins to misbehave. I had to understand what she was saying, and I drove off because I'm there with my entire family. This guy will waste you, and nothing will happen. This is Nigeria. That is the level of impunity which our police force has attained. It's unfortunate.
And for the first time that I can remember, the Nigerian government is seriously afraid, especially the arrogant government of Major General Muhammadu Buhari. You could see them, they are jittery, and that's why they are putting on this force. And I love, especially the Abuja protesters. They are amazing. They are amazing young people. For me, kudos to them. And I always say to people, even to me, that I would say, look, I'm not the one doing this protest. I didn't organize it. I just went there because they had tear gas them, and I'm like, not on my watch. And it was even that day I went there, I was all throughout, I was at the back, they were the ones doing everything. It was when the police came and they wanted to attack them. The first time that I came out in front and I stood, we stood. And then after a while, the police went down. I stood for almost over an hour within those pictures that you saw. When we did the knee, we stood up. I was speaking around. I was calling out to the police, the men and women that were there, how shameless they were coming out to attack the youth that are coming to just say to them, we want to leave. And after a while, I left that place. I went to pray. And as soon as I pray, I was just trying to take my smoothie. And then, boom, boom, with the shots started coming. They were throwing canisters. They
live,
were shooting.
Live ammunition?
Yes, yes. They were shooting and throwing live canisters. And then, you know, of course, the whole place scattered. All the youth ran away. But so as they were running, I went to one side. And for me, the mental was, I'm not going to run away. I mean, for crying out loud, I'm 46. I'm going to be 47 in December. By 2023, December 12th, if God spared my life, I'm going to be 50. For how long am I going to run away from problems? And so when they were doing, I didn't. So I just raised my fist high up and I was walking down slowly. They kept shooting at me, different shots. And I braced myself for the impact. I was thinking, okay, the bullet will soon hit me or whatever. Either a bullet or the canister will soon hit me. And I kept going along that way. Then I was able to, you know, come out of it, surprisingly, nothing. And with my hands still raised high, I went got out of the fence that they had cowardly built around themselves. I went to the main road, and then four policemen came. They came at me, and they were holding bottled water that this youth had gathered together because they wanted to sleep over there that day. So they held bottled water, and they were, you know, throwing them at me. So that's why a lot of people saw them thinking that I was being beaten. And they were being slapped. So when they were throwing that at me, it was one that glanced on me. And then one of them looked at me and then he cursed me in Hausa. And I cursed him back. And at the moment, I could see when he saw me, because maybe he thought because I was surrounded by them, there were about four or five policemen, and they were throwing these things at me. Maybe by the time he does that, I'm going to cower or something. No, if I'm going to die, I'm going to die standing. And I was waiting for it. I saw some of the reports where they said that, oh, they slapped me. None of them slapped me, because if any of them had slapped me, I'm going to slap that person back, because it's going to be self-defense. I don't care what uniform you're wearing. And if you're going to take me out, be ready to. I'm going to focus on one. And I will ensure that I make my boxing coach proud of me. The training I take all the time with my boxing coach, I would have descended on that person. If they're going to kill me, I'm going to ensure that one of them, I'm taking him along with me, so that they'll bury two people, not just one.